I promised you that I would be the reason why you took your first drink, and that's what's gonna happen. I'm gonna lead you down the lonely path to alcoholism, just like your father. I want to propose a toast to WrestleMania, to your dear old dad, and to you. Bottoms up, punk! Bottoms up! Drink up, punk, come on! Drink it up! Drink it up! It's good for you, come on!
And then Jericho would just go on to attack with his fist.
It's your destiny to be a drinker, isn't it? And now that you've had a taste, you're gonna want another one and another one. But I gotta warn you, punk, don't drink too much, because if you do, it goes straight to your head.
And then pow, oh, that was just way too much, way over the line. Face earlier today and absolutely sent chills down my spine.
I wanted to come out here and break the silence that's been surrounding me for the past week. I want to start off by saying that I understand that straight edge isn't a concept that everybody gets. I've heard it my entire life. I've heard it's just one drink, punk, or it's just one cigarette, you know, what's the big deal? And I understand that. I see that point of view, but let me explain it to you like this. Straight edge is a personal choice, and it wasn't a choice made so I could fit in somewhere. It wasn't a choice I made to be cool, because honestly, half my life it's made me exactly the opposite of that. It wasn't a choice I ever made to be trendy. It's a choice I made because it's exactly that. It is a way of life. And I've come out here time and time again, I've told you all exactly how proud I am to be straight edge. But the reasons I am straight edge is something that I've always held very close to the vest. It's something that I've tried to keep private for a couple of reasons. The first one is, I really don't think it's anybody else's business. Number two, who really cares, right? Who cares why I'm straight edge? Well, I explain it to you like this. I never wanted anybody to feel sorry for me, and I certainly never wanted to make excuses for myself. I told myself a long time ago that I was gonna make it to the top of the WWE. And I told myself if I make it to the top of the WWE, it was gonna be because I am the best damn wrestler in the world. Then along comes Chris Jericho. Who comes back and he tries to get in my head by saying that he's the best wrestler in the world. And when that doesn't work, Chris decides to destroy the privacy I've fought my entire life to keep. Chris tells the world that my father is an alcoholic, Chris makes up lies about my sweet little sister, saying she has a drug abuse problem. Chris defrocks my mother and says that I'm a bastard. And at WrestleMania, when his plan didn't work, when still none of these things he used to try to get under my skin actually get under my skin, and at WrestleMania, I beat him. No, at WrestleMania, I make Chris Jericho tap out. Chris Jericho takes it one step further. Chris Jericho takes it one step beyond. He takes it one step too far. And it was last week, and it was right out here. He pours whiskey all over my body, and he smashes a bottle over the back of my head. And as I lay there, in and out of consciousness, struggling to regain some semblance of where I was, I wasn't thinking, how bad am I hurt? Am I gonna be able to go on this international tour in 2 weeks? There was one thought in my head.